Welcome to the next session of Geotechnical Engineering 1 and Permeability. In today's class, we are going to discussing about the factors affecting permeability. In last class, we discussed about what is meant by permeability, what is meant by seepage velocity, and how the permeability will be vary in different type of soil mass we have seen. What is meant by hydraulic gradient? What is meant by head loss? All these terms we have discussed in the previous class. And coming to the factors affecting permeability, the first one is the particle size, and next one is the structure of soil mass, and the shape of particles, void ratio, properties of water, degree of saturation, adsorbed water, impurities in water. These are the different types of factors which will affect the flow of water through the soil mass. And this is the general equation which is useful for determination of the coefficient of permeability, where K is the coefficient of permeability, C d square E cube by 1 plus E gamma W by mu A B C D temperature. This is the equation. And if you see here, these are the various type of diagrams which will represents the how it will practically applicable for the flow of water through the soil mass. And coming to here, particle size. In particle size, what are the different type of size of the particles available in the practical field condition? The size of the particles either in the angular shape or rounded shape, are flaky or elongated, based on the shape of the particles or the size of the particles which will affect the flow of water through the soil mass, we will discuss in detail. Next one is the structure of soil mass. The structure of soil mass already we have discussed. We have single grain structure, honeycomb structure, flocculated structure, and dispersal structure. The flow of water in a flocculent structure is very less compared to the flow of water in the dispersed structure. And shape of the particles, what type of shape of the particles are available here, whether the size of the particles are in a square shape, rectangular, angular, irregular, angular or subangular, regular, irregular, that based on the shape of the particles also it will affect. Void ratio, how many number of voids are present in the particular type of the soil mass, whether in the densest state or loosest state. How number of voids are present in the soil mass, this will also affect the flow of water to the soil mass. Properties of water, nothing but flow of water, fluid, what type of fluid is available. And degree of saturation, if the soil mass having some voids present in it, it's block the water flowing of water to the soil mass. Whereas when the soil mass is completely saturated, if you pour some more water, it will be easily get coming out from this particular type of the soil mass. Adsorbed water, this is the condition water held by electrochemical forces existing on the soil surface, which results in the decreasing of the permeability. And impurities in water. In impurities in water means suppose any debris or any other materials presence of in this voids, it will block the flow of water through this particular type of the soil mass. In point by point, we'll see the factors affecting permeability. And coming to here, particle size. The permeability varies approximately as a square of its grain size, that is d10 square. It is depends upon the effective diameter of the grain size. That means percentage of the size of the particles passing 10%, how much amount of size is having, that will determine the coefficient of permeability. If you see gravel having the larger size, hence larger the void, because of larger the void, the connectivity it will be more, hence why gravel having the more permeability. Whereas fine grain soils, silt or clay having very smaller in particle size, hence why very small in particle wide, hence why flow of water through the soil mass also it will be very less. Based on this effective size of the particles, we can estimate the flow of water through that particular type of the soil mass. And coming to the void ratio, when the soil mass in the loose state, it is having the more number of voids, hence permeability it will be more. Then the soil mass is in the densest state, there will be less number of voids, interconnectivity is very less, hence wire shape will be less. And again, if you see here, in this condition, if you observe here, these are the smaller particles and these are the larger particles. Larger particles will have the more voids, smaller particles will have the less number of voids, are not interconnected. And so, while flowing water through this particular type of soil mass, again through this particular type of soil mass, in this water immediately will come more, and this will take much time. And again, if you see here, here also the voids are more, hence why while pouring water into this particular type of soil mass, immediately will come out of from this. If you consider in the same volume, if you consider this, if you pour the water because of less number of void spaces, water it will take much time to come out. And properties of pore fluid. Pore fluids are the fluids that occupy pore spaces in a soil or rock. Permeability is directly proportional to the unit weight of pore fluid and inversely proportional to the viscosity of the pore fluid. That means in this particular type of the soil mass, if you pour the water, water have viscous nature. Because of this viscosity, water will offer the more resistance to flow through this particular type of soil mass. Whereas if you keep any honey or any other material, viscous material, it will oppose the flow of water to the soil mass, hence why permeability it will be very less for viscous fluids, which having the more viscosity, which resistance of flow it will be very less. And based on the different type of fluids, based on the viscosity of the fluid conditions, permeability it will be discuss. It will be more the permeability and less will be the permeability, less will be the viscosity, more will be the flow of water to the soil mass. And coming to here, shape of the particles, already we have discussed. We have different type shape of particle. We are having angular, subangular, rounded, well-rounded, sub-round, different types of particles are there. Based on the specific surface area of the particles, the permeability also it will be depend. Permeability is inversely proportional to specific surface area. Example, an angular soil have more specific surface area compared to the rounded soil. Therefore, soil with angular particles is less permeable than soil with rounded particles. That means the particles whose are having the more specific surface area, the flow of water traveling through that more specific surface area, which results the reduction of the flow of water through the soil mass, which get reduced the permeability of the soil mass. Clay particles, if you take, there are the surface like structures which offers more resistance to flow of water to the soil mass. Hence, clay particles will give the very less permeability compared to gravel and sand particles. And coming to next one is the structure of soil mass. For same void ratio, the permeability is more for a flocculated structure as compared to the dispersed structure. In a flocculated structure, the more number the void, but the connectivity will be very less as compared to the dispersed structure. Based on the compaction of the soil mass, the soil orientation change, and it may be get converted to single grain stonic honeycomb to flocculated to dispersal structure based on the size of the particles present in the shape of the particles and what type of compaction you are getting to the particular type of the soil mass, the structure of the soil mass will make it change. Next one is the degree of saturation. The permeability of partially saturated soil is less than that of fully saturated soil. And again, if you observe in this diagram, this is the partially saturated soil mass. Here some more air voids or air voids are there while entering, while flowing water this partially saturated soil mass. Water again should have to come this position, and again should have to reach this position, should have to again should have to form the one more regular channel through these voids. Hence why it takes much time while pouring water in this partially saturated soil. Whereas in a fully saturation condition, the all voids are already created this flow path. Hence why while entering water, this particular type of the soil mass, the water is easily get out from this particular type of the soil mass. Hence fully saturated soil have the more permeability compared to the partially saturated soil mass. And coming to the adsorbed water. edge of the water means the water held by electrochemical forces existing on the soil surface. This electrochemical forces existing on the soil which offers the resistance of flow through the soil mass. And if you see here, edge of the water means a thin microscopic film of water surrounded by individual soil grains. This water is not free to move and hence reduce the effective pore spaces and thus decrease the coefficient of permeability. Again, if you take here a soil particle, in the soil particle surrounded by the this water particle, because of this water surrounded by the water particle, it does not allow water easily to go out from this pore spaces, which results the decrease in the permeability of the soil mass. Next one is the entrapped air and organic impurities. The organic impurities and the entrapped air obstruct the flow and coefficient of permeability is reduced due to presence. That means in this particular type of the soil mass, the voids are get filled with this air or other organic impurities or debris, which will block the passage of water to that particular type of the soil mass, which results in the decreasing of the permeability. And coming to here, temperature of the soil mass, as the viscosity of the pore fluid decreases with the temperature, permeability is increases with the temperature. As unit weight of pore fluid does not change, which must change in the temperature. That means if temperature is increasing, viscosity will get decreasing because of this permeability is increasing. When temperature is decreasing, viscosity is increasing, hence results in the decreasing of the permeability of the soil mass. How this is the temperature is affect the permeability of the soil mass. And next one is the stratification of the soil mass. This stratification of soil mass, the soil mass arranged in the underground surface, how many type of layers are there and what are the particular type of the soil layers, all will affect the flow of water through the soil mass. Stratified soils are those soils which are formed by layer upon layer on the earth or dust deposited on each layer. If the flow is parallel to the layers of stratification, the permeability is maximum, while the flow in perpendicular direction occurs with minimum permeability. That means if you see the different type of soil layers in this direction, if you flow the water like this, and if you have to transfer from one layer to one other layer to second layer like that, it will take more time for the stratification of the soil mass. That means flow of water in a horizontal direction is more than the flow of water in the parallel direction. And coming to here, next topic is the hydraulic conductivity, that is the coefficient of permeability. The coefficient of permeability is nothing but the flow of water through the soil mass. How much amount of water is flowing to particular type of the soil mass, we can determine by using different types of laboratory experimentations as well as field experimentation and indirect methods. Those experimentations now we will discuss. And if you see here, permeability is also known as hydraulic conductivity. Permeability is also known as hydraulic conductivity. Hydraulic conductivity can be represented or marked as K. Our K value is one of the principal and most important soil hydrology or hydraulic characteristics, and it is important factor in transport in the soil and used in the all equation of groundwater or subsurface water flow. Based on this K value, we can predetermine the how much amount of water can flow through particular type of the soil mass. Suppose if you take the gravel soil, what is the flow of water and how much time it is take flowing through the soil in a particular depth or particular length. Whereas if you take the clay soil, for clay soil how much time it is taking flow of water to that particular type of soil, you can determine by using this coefficient of permeability K. And coming to here, the value of hydraulic conductivity varies widely for a different type of soil mass. That means coefficient of permeability, it will be vary for gravel, sand, clay, silt based on the voids interconnected. The hydraulic conductivity can be determined by laboratory experimentations. The hydraulic conductivity of a unsaturated soil is lower and increased rapidly with the degree of saturation. Already we have seen in the factors affecting permeability, if you take some container and if you there is soil sample is partially saturated, while filling the voids, it will take much time to come out from the sample. whereas the sample is get fully saturated, again if you pour the water, it will come immediately after completely saturation of the soil mass. Why? Because the soil mass will create a regular path. The coefficient of permeability also varies with temperature upon the viscosity of the water dependence. And what type of, normally we will use the fluid in the permeability. If it is the more temperature, lesser will be the viscosity, more will be the permeability of the soil mass. The coefficient of permeability can also be represented by the equation called coefficient of permeability. By using different types of laboratory experimentations, we can determine the coefficient of permeability K. And next we will see the different type of laboratory experimentation determination of coefficient of permeability. And coming to here, determination of coefficient of permeability K can be determined by using these following methods. And first one is the laboratory methods. Laboratory methods again get classified into variable head permeability test or a constant head permeability test. This variable head permeability test is basically useful for the fine grain soil such as silt and clay soils. Whereas a constant head permeability test will be useful for the coarse grain soil such as gravel and sand. Mostly sandy soil, we can determine the coefficient of permeability by using the constant head method. And coming to the field experimentation, these field experiments are very expensive, and these field experiments are again get classified into pumping out test and pumping in test. These are the two experiments how practically you can determine the flow of water to the soil mass in the field at the site. And next one we are having the one more method called indirect method. These indirect methods are nothing but based on the index properties or based on the particle sizes, based on the particle diameters, we can determine the how much amount of water can flow through that particular type of the soil mass. In this indirect method, first one we are having the computation from the particle size. Particle size distribution based on that how much size of the particles are there, whether the soil mass is well graded, poorly graded, uniformly graded, or the effective size of the particles, how much diameter, how much percentage is there. Based on that also we can determine the coefficient of permeability. And as well as from consolidation test data also we can determine the coefficient of permeability. And next one is the capillarity permeability test. This is a capillarity permeability test also which will give the determination of the coefficient of permeability flow of water through the particular type of the soil mass. These experimentations one by one we will discuss now. And coming to the coefficient of permeability or hydraulic conductivity K. Hydraulic conductivity K is a measure of the soil permeability, that is nothing but the flow of water through the soil medium. K is determined in the laboratory by using these following two methods. First one is the constant head test and the second one is the falling head test. K is the coefficient of permeability is expressed in distance by time, that means how much length it is traveled in a particular unit time, which represents the coefficient of permeability, that is nothing but the flow of water through the soil mass, how much length it is traveled in a particular time. Hydraulic conductivity or coefficient of permeability represents same. Hydraulic conductivity also we can term it as the coefficient of permeability, which is represented by the symbol called constant K or coefficient of permeability K. And determination of coefficient of permeability by using the constant head test. This is a laboratory experimentation we are performing. Based on this laboratory experimentation, we are collecting some field soil. We can also use in the laboratory soil to determine the how much amount of water can flow through the particular type of the soil mass. The permeability test is a measure of the rate of flow of water through the soil mass. If you take out any sufficient quantity of soil from the field and if you pour water through the soil mass in the required density, you may can find out the how much quantity of water falling through the particular type of the soil mass. In this test, water is forced by known constant pressure through a soil specimen of known dimension, and the rate of flow is determined. One regular container with 10 cm diameter and 14 by 4 cm height with cylindrical mold will take, in that will fill with two porous stones. After that we will set up two arrangements. Based on that arrangements we will determine the permeability. By seeing that we will explain. This test is used primarily to determine the suitability of sands and gravels for drainage purpose. This test is used for primarily to determine the suitability of sands and gravels for drainage purpose, and it is made only on remolded samples. And coming to here, constant head test. The constant head test is used primarily for the coarse grains. Already we have explained, especially for the sandy soil, the constant head test is useful. This test is based on the assumption of laminar flow, where K is independent of I, low values of hydraulic gradient. This test applies a constant head of water to each end of soil in the perimeter. And coming to here, in this type of laboratory setup, the water supply at the inlet is adjusted in such a way that the difference of head between the inlet and outlet remains constant during the test period. After a constant flow rate is established, water is collected in a graduated flux to know the duration and how much amount of quantity of water is collected in that particular container. And again, if you see here, this is the setup for the determination of coefficient of permeability for the laboratory experimentation. And if you see here, this is the regular cylindrical mold having length L and internal diameter having D. And in both soil sample top and bottom, we are placing two porous stones or porous disc, which are having more permeable or 10 times permeable than the water type of soil we are using here. And here, this is the water supply or constantly water supply tank. And here, this is the piezometer we are inserting at the top portion below the exactly bottom of the porous stone. And one more piezometer we are inserting here. While by using this constant head, we are entering the water. The water will make it traveling from this porous stone to this soil mass. And while entering water in this traveling from this position, the water will create some head at this piezometer at this level. This level will measure in the laboratory. Again, based on the type of the soil condition, what are the various type of soil available, void ratio, impurity, degree of saturation, adsorbed water, all these condition factors affecting permeability, based on this water will get traveled from this position to this here. And the water will again, in bottom we are providing one more piezometer. In this piezometer again, the water also again will create up to in this level. And in bottom we are creating this inlet. That means the water is getting traveled from this entire soil length, and the water we are collecting in the container. In this container, it will create the head, and this from this container, the water is collecting in a graduated jar. In this graduated jar, we are measuring how much amount of water is collected in a particular type of the, in a particular time. That means if you see here, this is the length of the soil sample. This is the hydraulic head at this level, and this is the hydraulic head at this level. The head difference we can get from this point to this point, how much height it is available here and how much height is available here. These two points will give the hydraulic head difference or head difference, and where H is the length of the soil sample or length of the drainage pond. You should have to always remember this. L is the length of the drainage path. That means how much amount of length the water is traveling. And the where from Darcy's law we are having the formula small q equal to AV, where small q is the velocity, discharge velocity. And by using Darcy's law we are having the formula capital Q by T equal to AV. From continuity equation, velocity equal to discharge by cross section area, where small q. Small q is nothing but the discharge velocity. Discharge velocity is nothing but collection of water in the graduated jar divided by time, where capital Q and T are the water collected in the graduated jar in a particular time. That means Q by T equal to AV, nothing but discharge velocity. Here small q equal to AV, where small q is the discharge velocity, that is nothing but a collection of water in the jar divided by time particular time t. Hence small q plays in replacing VDR with capital Q by T. Capital Q by T equal to AV, where T we are sending that side, hence why capital Q equal to volume of water collected in the jar equal to cross sectional area of this cylinder into velocity of water flow from this direction, that is nothing but distance by time, and the t is the time, and this velocity from Darcy's law, we know that a into from Darcy's law we are having v equal to k into I. Velocity of liquid or velocity of fluid, it will be depend upon the what type of soil having, and it is having how much permeability, and what is the hydraulic head loss or head difference we are getting. I is the hydraulic gradient, that is h divided by length of the soil sample. How much head loss divided by length of the soil mass will give the hydraulic gradient I. From this we should have to calculate the coefficient of permeability k. The coefficient of permeability k equal to ql by aht. Coefficient of permeability k equal to ql by aht, where q is the collection of water in the graduated cylinder, l is the length of the this cylindrical mold, a is the cross sectional area of the mold, and h is the head difference between the top and bottom piezometers, and time is the volume of water collected in this particular jar with respect to this collection of water. This is the how we are calculating the coefficient of permeability k in the laboratory by using the constant head method for the coarse grain soils. In the similar way, we will determine the coefficient of permeability for fine grain soils such as silt and clay by using the variable head test. And again, if you see here, for constant head test we are having, where capital Q is the volume of water collected in the graduated jar, A is the cross sectional area of the soil sample, T is the duration of water collection in the sample. And next, one more experimentation, we are having the falling head test. Relatively less permeable soils will conduct the falling head test. This variable head test or falling head test will be useful for the very less permeable soils, because of the collection of water it will take much time, hence why hydraulic head difference will consider in this condition. Water flows through the sample from standard pipe attached to the top cylinder. It is also regular type of the attachment what you have seen in the previous condition. The head of water h changes with time as flow occurs through the soil. At a different times the head of water is recorded. Based on this head loss and time, we can determine the flow of water to that particular type of the soil mass. A typical arrangement of the falling head permeability test is shown in the next slide. Water from the standard flow through the soil, the initial head difference is h1 at time equal to 0 recorded, and water is allowed to flow through the soil specimen which such that final head difference at time t2 is h2. That means if you see here, this is the regular setup arrangement for the determination of coefficient of permeability for a variable head test. And this is the cylindrical mold. In this cylindrical mold, top we have attached one porous stone, and bottom also we have attached one more porous stone. In this porous stone, we have attached one regular standard pipe with a cross sectional area as A. And in this standard pipe, we are having a different type of representation for measuring of the head difference. Here there are the values 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 80, 90, 100, like this. The measuring measurements will be available for this standard pipe. And at a time t equal to t1, the head difference it will be very less. That means there is no head loss will be available at time, particular time t equal to 0. At a time t equal to t2, we are allowing the inlet water flowing through the particular type of the cross section. At this particular time, the head difference is happening from this to this. And if you observe here, from this level to this level, this is the h1. At the initial time, there is no head loss. With the passage of time, the water flowing through the soil mass, the head loss is get differentiating. That the head loss get differentiating, we are taking it as h2. That is h2. And here the collection of water, what we are collecting, it is not necessary for us to calculate the coefficient of permeability. We are having only, we should have to measure only the head difference. For the falling head test, the velocity of fall in the standard pipe V equal to minus dH by dt. That means this is the standard pipe. How much head difference? This is the height of the stand pipe. How much head is the difference? That is dh. And where dt is the time difference from t1 to t2. How much its time difference represents the velocity of flow of water through soil mass. That v equal to minus dh by dt. Minus represents the indicates the decreasing of water level in the standard pipe. Minus which represents the decreasing of water level in the standard pipe. And falling head test, the flow into the sampler Q in equal to minus A into dH by dt. That means where A is the cross sectional area of the soil sample, while you are opening the inlet, the water will make it travel into the soil mass with a particular time with giving head difference as a H. And so water entering into the soil mass Q in equal to minus A into dH by dt, where A small a equal to cross section area of the standard pipe. From Darcy's law, the flow out is Q out equal to AV. That means AV, V is nothing but KI, V is nothing but KI. And where I is the ideal head loss, H divided by L, where H is the head difference, this is the initial height and this is the difference height, h1 minus h2, if you get difference, you will get the head difference h, that k into h divided by l, that equal into a cross sectional area. By equating the inlet discharge equal to outlet discharge, based on this equation, we can calculate the coefficient of permeability. That k into I h by l into a cross sectional area equal to minus a into standard pipe cross section area A into dH by dt. That means head difference divided by time difference. And separating variables and integrating on with respect to limits. That means we are sending this dt this side and h to that side. Separating and integrating, we are getting this formula. That means k into a by l into integral t1 to t2 dt equal to a into h2 to h1. That means dh by h. By making integration for this both equation, we can finally find out the relation. That relation k equal to 2.303 into al divided by at into log h1 by h2, where 2.303 is the constant value, where small a is the cross sectional area of the standard pipe and l is the length of the drainage path or length of the water flowing, and capital A is the cross sectional area of the soil sample, and T is the collection of water. That means the head difference is happen in that particular time, where h1 and h2 is the head difference at particular time t equal to 0, and h2 is the head difference at particular time t equal to t2. This is the final equation for calculation of the coefficient of permeability for falling head experimentation. These two equations are very much important for determining the coefficient of permeability for coarse grain soil as well as fine grain soils. In next class, we will see about the determination of coefficient of permeability for the field test. If you consider the field at outside confined aquifer or unconfined aquifer, how the coefficient of permeability flow of water it will be happening in the field condition, that we will see in the next subsequent lectures. Up to now, this is the thing for the coefficient of permeability. Thank you.